California's Attorney General Kamala Harris also zeroed in on that point during her convention speech last night. California, of course, as you know, strong blue state, voted a Democrat in the last five presidential elections. It has 55 delegates, more than any other state. Last night, Harris strongly endorsed the president's economic policies, saying the American dream belongs to all of us.
We firmly believe in the American ideal that our country should work for everyone. That ideal is written into our laws, the rules of the road that create a level playing field in this country. Those are the rules I became Attorney General to uphold. And those are the rules Mitt Romney would have us roll back.
Kamala Harris, who's joining us. Kamala, good to see you. It's been a very active convention,
yes,
I know.
It has.
Tell us a little bit about the points you were making. One of the things you talked about is the unemployment situation, but you also talked about housing, and that's something in your state that you have made really a cause in terms of addressing those issues. What needs to happen on a national scale? Because there's still a lot of folks who are really in a housing crisis.
Right, and across the state. California was the hardest hit, but we also have the largest population. And I've traveled throughout the country, most recently Ohio. And what ended up happening is because of really, frankly, failure to regulate certain activities on Wall Street, there were abuses. And it resulted in a situation where millions of families have lost their homes. And so the conversation last night was to talk about what needs to happen to, one, ensure that that never happens again, but also to correct the course. And that is about bringing relief to those homeowners. It is about requiring accountability and consequence for wrongdoers and people who engage in predatory activities against hardworking middle-class families who are in pursuit of the American dream.
And you believe that can happen on a national level, that would be effective on a national level?
Absolutely right. And I think the president has been very forceful in his support of the work of the 49 attorneys general who are part of a multi-state focus on the activity of the five big banks and what should happen around a consequence for robo-signing activity. The president was very supportive of and very much a leader around the $25 billion that we brought back to the various states to bring relief to those homeowners by way of principal reduction and giving them an ability to refinance their loans.
I want to play for our audience a little clip here, because you seem pretty emotional about this when you talk about your first home as a kid.
Doing nothing while the middle class is hurting, that's not leadership. Loose regulations and lax enforcement, that's not leadership. That's abandoning our middle class.
Well, why were you so moved by that story?
Well, you know, I told the story of my personal story. I was 13 when my mother bought our first home, and my sister and I were incredibly excited, and we were excited as children because I remember my mother being so proud. And when we were going through this discussion about consequence and California's role in the national settlement, our position was very forceful about protecting these homeowners and giving them support, because it was based on my own experience. You know, I would talk to people and say, you know, have you ever known folks who are really proud of their lawn? Right?
Yeah, right, sure.
It's those folks who were very much in this process where they were going through robo-signing activity or on a dual-track process, and we need to bring them relief because they're hard-working, good people, middle-class families in America who needed to have relief.
You know, you're a big part of this campaign. A lot of people think that you might become the next attorney general. There's all this buzz around you. Do you have any ambitions for that?
No, you know, I love being the attorney general of California. I think being the Attorney General of California, as any Attorney General can tell you from any one of the states, it is an office that can do very good work that benefits a lot of people. One of my primary responsibilities is to protect consumers. So that then extends to the work we did around the housing crisis and the foreclosure crisis. It extends to the work that we've been doing in California around privacy and the need to support and protect privacy concerns and issues as it relates to technology and the beautiful innovation that technology is. And so there is work that can be done on a daily basis that has an incredible impact, and so goes California, goes the rest of the country, as far as I'm concerned.
All
so
right. Yeah, people are calling you the female Barack Obama. I think they should call him the male Kamala Harris. What do you think?
You know what? There is only one Barack Obama, and thank God he is the president of the United States, and we're going to do everything we can, and we will reelect him as president of the United States so he can continue to do the good work that makes us so very proud
All
as
right.
Americans.
Have a good convention.
Thank
Kamala,
you.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Suzanne.